Hello, wonderful, amazing video game type people, and welcome back to Darkest Dungeon. Today, we go for the Inchoate Flesh, without really truly knowing what the Inchoate Flesh really is. Whew. I googled the word Inchoate, I don't know how to say it. I googled it, and it means not fully formed, so not fully formed flesh, which makes me think this is going to be some weird, blighty, diseasey, maybe spawning pieces of itself type fight. Kind of like slimes. I'm expecting something like that. I'm not sure what that means in terms of what we have to do, but from the get-go, I want high damage for starters. For starters, that's it. We just need a bunch of amazingly high damage people that can fight in the, hopefully it's pretty good. And we bleed. Ugh. Stop being so diseased, Jose. We could fix it, though, with Anna. Is Anna a worn staff? Oh my gosh, yeah, there's no way we're not using Anna. Sorry, we basically have to use Anna. And that's gonna level her up. Oh, that's okay. Anna will be great. Okay. So we basically have to use her. Love it. Is this the second fight in the Warrens or the first one? I think this is the second one. Yeah, okay, this is the second fight. That's cool. Okay, so Anna can hang out. Yeah. Did we do a Warrens run just now? Is that what that was? Might have been. Fated and unyielding. I don't know if Brian would be good for the Warrens. He's got Fated and he's got unyielding, and we could make him hit nasty hard. Hendry. Hendry's good in general. Warrens tactician. Alright, yep. Fear of unholy. Well, hopefully the inchoate flesh is not unholy. That's kind of what I'm going to hope for. I could totally take Alex. I'm down with that. That's really cool with the Warrens tactician. If we're going to the Warrens, if we're going for this, I want as much high damage as humanly possible. All of them Warrens people. Okay, and actually Munaville is quite good for the weld, so I am going to fix Munaville's trouble. Let's go for brothel. By all means, oh, we can do that. That's kind of cool. Increase number of slots. No, I don't want that. No, yeah, go ahead. You deserve some loving. A hot bath and a companion to make it warmer, please. Okay. Now, what's interesting to me is that we do need something more. We need something more here. Beast, Eldritch, Unerring, God-fearing, Stress Eater. He's not awful. Jose could be useful for this. He really could. He's got that darn hemophilia that could be a problem. Ooh, of course we want Gulafra, but will it level Gulafra? It will. Ah, I hate that. I don't want him to level up, man. Thanatophobia, nervous, love interest, evasive, fast healer. I mean, it's not a bad idea to take a healer, potentially, right? And torment is good. I would prefer people that won't level up from this. I like the idea of somebody who does really high damage. While Brian is really good, necromania. Oh, I guess we could. I don't know if it's gonna. Is the inchoate flesh gonna mix us up? Hopefully not. Let's take Brian in the hopes that Brian can do some crazy hits and that we don't get mixed up. Hendry, of course, is amazing, and there's very little that isn't good about using Hendry. So. What I'd like to do, I think, is, that's actually fascinating. We got triage, field dressing, encourage marching plan, restring crossbow. No, maybe there's somebody else. Maybe there's someone else. Vivil. No, man. Ooh, could we use Myron? We might be able to use Myron. Myron could maybe be used for this thing. This compulsive bastard who It has really nothing that bad. Beyond compulsive. Compulsive's pretty bad, but... What? Who? Oh, no. It's a choice between Brian and Myron. Oh, no. Tough on Aaron. Okay. Oh, I'm nervous, man. Hey, you're perfect. You're just perfect, Anna. You got this. Also, that's... Wow. Holy cow. Mad speed. Is there anything else we can do to boost your damage? Holy cow. If we knew what the inchoate flesh was, we could incorporate that somehow. I don't think we need to worry about your accuracy, per se. We could, though. We could totally switch that out for accuracy, range, skills. But the trouble is that we're not actually using range skills. See, that's the problem. Go ahead and do that. And go by rarity. Oh my gosh, imagine what that would do. A legendary bracer on our main damage dealer, in this case Anna. Mix that with the Warren's tactician. Is there anything we can do to boost that speed up a bit? Oh, because now you're talking insane, insane damage. Oh my god, okay, mix that with the Ancestor's Candle. Okay, and you've got... Oh my god. Just the damage is what you have. I actually really like that because I have very limited concerns about... Oh my gosh, Warren's Tactician. Okay, mix that with Legendary Bracer. Mix that with that. We've got... What are we talking here? What is this? 30... 20, that's plus 50% damage. That's ridiculous. Ridiculous. What is that going to be? It's going to be 9 to 19. And that doesn't even include the extra 40%. That's almost 100% extra damage on lunge attacks. So we're going to go with that. That's happening. Anna will be our killer. Okay. I think we'll be fine with this. Healer's Gift. So you can heal... Heal during camping. That's pretty cool. Yeah. Let's go for making you the sort of healer. I think that will work. And I think that makes me happy. That means you've now got a high chance to hit. That's everybody's happy. Okay. As for our dear friend the leper. Yeah. We'll go for that, and presumably something else. Something that might, what do you do again? Oh, leper friend, besides doing damage and withstand and solemnity. All good things, don't get me wrong, all amazing things, but what exactly? Nothing really, hey? Perhaps... heals received and stress heals received would work. That might work. That would mean that with the Ancestral Scroll, you get a little bit more stressed, but you'll be able to heal yourself pretty darn well. Or, admittedly, I don't know that we use you to debuff. And you can't have two redemption armlets. Dang it. A speed stone, maybe? You could do a speed stone. Could do a speed stone. Max, oh shit, health stone adds 4 hit points. That's pretty cool. Let's go for the health stone instead and just hope for the best. Okay, it's not gonna be amazing, but it'll be fine. And we can, I think, upgrade your... we can't upgrade your weapon any further. That should be fine. A little bit more health, a little bit less speed. And then of course our friend the jester. Okay, so for our beloved friend the Jester, whatever will we do? Well, the key thing with the Jester, Alex here, with this Warren's Tactician, he's going to get higher damage anyways. We're going to boost all his things because we're going for a boss fight. The finale is going to be good. I think finale mixed with solo might just be lovely. So we'll switch Harvest for solo, and I think I can work with that. Yeah, switch Harvest for soul. Right, but we do actually have to give him some stuff. Things and stuffs. So, presumably for him, higher damage is better. Accuracy is good also, if we can somehow boost that up, but I think it's melee accuracy. Deathblow resist. Deathblow resist, I mean, whatever. Alright. Yeah. Solar Crown is kind of cool. Less stress. Less stress is always love. Ooh, what's this? Oh. Ah, bloody dice. That's a thing that we have. No, he's going to be moving around a lot anyways. So, move resist doesn't matter. Give him some slippery boots. And, frankly, the Unholy Slayer's Ring, maybe. Maybe. Speedstone would be good as well. As would the Survival Guide. All of these things would be great. Let's go Speedstone. I have a hard time going wrong with the Speedstone. So I think it's pretty good. The Fear of Unholy is really unfortunate. I wish there was a way to boost his actual accuracy. Nonetheless, okay. Let's use this party for some reason. Even though I know that the, using a leper can be pretty sketch. Pretty sketch. Alright, there's Alex, Henry, Brian. Where's number four? Do we actually have a level two? Oh yeah, we've got Anna. We're using Anna for this. No, that's okay. Our brightest and best. Okay, that means we have to go to the guild. Oh, we can upgrade everything. Oh my goodness. That's amazing. This is going to make things even... Oh, that's glorious. Look at that. Look at that glorious higher accuracy chance by 5. Yeah, it's good. It means that if we're going up against really high dodge opponents, that's still useful. Oh, that is crazy. Okay, well, Anna's going to be the only one to go for the really expensive upgrades, so we might as well do it. I don't want her to die. Higher accuracy. Yeah, just go for it. All of the monies. Blight. Does Blight do actually any good here? Well, it increases the Blight chance, so that's nice. And that's quite nice there. Plus 7 accuracy crit mod. Okay, that's fine. A little bit that was a little bit expensive. Wow, training is super expensive. But okay, no, Anna's earned it. Definitely. I think she just got that. The thing that we got there, that's really cool. The achievement that unlocked, I think, on Anna's kill was have one hero kill at least 50 opponents. That means Anna has single-handedly killed 50 opponents without even reaching level 3. That's insane. Utterly insane. No, we're good with the leper. Who is this? This is Brian? Tell me about Henry. What do we have here? Okay, so my key problem with Henry... don't get me wrong, I would love Sniper's Mark. I think that's a great idea. Maybe we should get it. Sniper's Mark, Battlefield Bandage. The trouble with Henry is that without giving her something like Blind Fire, if we get shuffled around a lot, we just won't have any way of hurting someone. So let's get Blind Fire as well. I think that may be everyone. Henry, Brian. Whew. Stuff's getting real. Alright, I'm always a little bit more nervous before these big fights. Okay, Finale, Dirk Stab, yeah, that's fine. Battle Ballad, I definitely want to go solo. I'm not sure if I want Inspiring Tune. I'm not sure. Let's just grab it just in case we need to get it later. Okay, we've spent a lot of gold. That's okay, we're doing better, considering this is a boss fight that we're going into. We're doing a little bit better. Can we fix some diseases? Jose, get rid of your bleed resist. Anything we can do here? No. Go for it. And I think we got one more diseased human being in here somewhere. No? Okay. Okay, folks. This is it as we go for the inchoate flesh. No real idea what's going on. We're really banking everything on Anna's freaking high... That's going to be 8 speed, I think. Freaking high... First lunge move. Yeah, it'll be one of the two. It'll be both. Either way, it'll work. Okay. High speed, high damage. This should be a good party. I think we've got some heal. How are we doing for... Before we go, I just want to check if we have any good boosters here. Reflection will be very nice. Okay, so we want to go camping before we fight that fight. So Reflection, Tiger's Eye, Night Move, Snuff Box, probably. A bit bummed that we don't have Restring Crossbow. Let's go ahead and get Restring Crossbow. Ooh, that's exciting. You get to see me spend a bunch of things for cheaper survivalist things. Okay. Where's Henry? Boop. Alright, so I can spend 1750 or reduce cost of training camping skills by 10%. How nice does it look? Does it look the same? I can't tell. I think we'll leave it at that. I don't want to actually waste all of my bonfire. Would be kind of cool. Woo! Boost that bonfire higher. Oh. 1575. Okay, we reduced it a bit. Only medium and long quests feature camping. I know. Let's go Restring Crossbow. Heroes can... Oh, it takes more than brawn. Heroes can only have 4 camping skills active at a time. Toggle the skills on and off by clicking on them. Go for it. Boom! Love it. So all of them could actually learn another camping skill if we want to spend the money on it. Okay. Here goes nothing. I think we're good. I'm just going to check real quick to make sure everyone's... There we go. Everyone's on the skills that I want for them. I think that'll do. That's amazing. You're going to just massacre everyone left, right, and center. And I think we want to get rid of your suppressing fire for... presumably blind fire for now. And then mark. Sniper's mark before going for the boss fight. Okay. I'm feeling good. Inchoate flesh. Alright, we're going to take all of the food. We're here to kill a boss, and we're here to survive while doing it. All the food. All the torches. Alright. I think all the shovels. No, that's too many shovels. All of the medicinal herbs for the debuff on the... For getting rid of the debuffs. We'll take all of the bandages. And that leaves us with holy water and keys. Now, naturally, we want keys. You always want keys. A little bit of anti-venom. A little bit of holy water. Okay. I think with 4 shovels we should probably be able to do this. I think this should be good. This feels good. I'm not missing anything. No. Okay.
My zeal for blood rituals and summoning rites had begun to ebb, as each attempt invariably brought only failure and disappointment. Progress was halting, and the rapidly accumulating surplus of wasted flesh had become burdensome.
Oh gosh, that's terrifying.
The thing is more terrible than I can describe. An incoherent jumble of organ, sinew, and bone.
Well, okay. That's fascinating. So we know that he's going to be somewhere in here, presumably in either this corner or this corner. If we can get here and get a scouting, I'm tempted to go north because there's a curio there, and I feel like the more curios we encounter, the higher the chance that we will get a positive boon, like one of those...
Such blockages are unsurprising. These tunnels predate even the earliest settlers.
You know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about the wine casks. Something like a wine cask would be quite lovely.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted, and purpose is made clear.
Alright. Looks pretty straightforward so far. Wine cask! Fuck yeah! Except, if we use a wine cask... if we use the wine cask, we can't camp. Sneaky deaky, we'll come back for the wine cask. Screw you. Yeah, because I'm a pimp like that. I know where the wine is. We're going to get drunk after camping and then do the boss fight. Obviously. Oh, no. Don't do it. Don't do it. Thank you. All right. Let's see what we can do. Okay. Not the best. High crit chance, but man, you've got low damage. This is what happens when you don't pack the damage on this guy. Still, that doesn't mean that we can't kill the swine slasher pretty well. Ooh. A little bit of rotten luck there. Blind fire gets to go next for some reason. I guess that doesn't matter then. Good thing we have it. You get to do your lunge. Oh my gosh, this is not working out at all like I had hoped. Still, that is a glorious, glorious lunge. Glorious beyond all reason.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
Good job, Anna. Great dodge, too. Hook where it hurts. No, don't do it! Ah. I don't have that kind of healing, bud. What are your odds of actually striking? Oh, pretty good. Not bad. You do decent damage, but you do better damage in rank 1. Still, we'll take it. Alright, kill. Wow.
Their formation is broken. Ooh. Maintain the offensive.
Anna is just utterly terrifying. Go for the kill on the Swine Slasher, please.
Press disadvantage. Give them no quarter.
Ooh. Presumably a solo is not a poor life choice. Nice. And it should miss. Okay, I thought it was gonna miss. At least we didn't get a disease. I'm okay with that. Ugh, the leper is unfortunate for this party. I should have thought about that. Oh well. Dirk stab. Nice, good job on hitting. Go for the kill. Oh, come on now. Critical vomit! No! If that's the case, use poison darts.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Alright, that was fine. Can you use... Oh yeah, you can withstand. You're pretty pimp. Alright. Anyways, look, it's not an awful... makeshift dining table. Food scraps. Use medicinal herbs. Nice. We didn't get a lot, but we got enough to be awesome. So... Ooh. Very nice. Okay, so now we presumably at this point we know that the boss fight is going to be there. Fascinating. I almost feel like I should go back and get that, because I don't think we're going to go all the way back here for it. But, you never know. You never know. We'll leave it for now. Ooh, that's fun. What's this? Let me see. I must see. No! Don't do it. Violently ill. Well, I think we got one, so let's, fix you right up there. What is that? Oh, there's a fight. No, don't munch on us.
Unnerved. Unbalanced.
Alright. I get it. You're in it for keepsies. Asshole.
Onslaught. Destroy them.
So much for healing. Oh, well. Ooh. That is terrifying. That is utterly terrifying.
Victory.
Feel free to get rid of the
victory, nonetheless.
Alright. This is really a one-hit wonder team or whatever. Everything is focused around Anna just being super pimp. Can we give you food? Yeah, we can. Okay. That's nice. More curios. Alright. Fight. Okay, these fights aren't so bad. Easy piece of lemon squeezy. Oh, that is amazing. Just regularly hitting 25s. By all means, go for Dirk Stab. Nice. More money. That's why I took
as
the...
victories mount, so too will resistance.
That's why I took the money, by the way. Do we want to read? Do we want to set it on fire and get stressed out? Probably not. Let's keep going. Just undue stress. It's unnecessary on a boss level like this. We don't need that. We don't need that kind of crap in our lives.
The way is lit. The path is clear.
We gotta fight.
We require only the strength to follow it.
Right. Can we surprise them? No, we didn't surprise them. Okay, that's fine. We do get to use a finale. And hopefully... You know, hopefully we can actually effectively use the finale to kill the swine wretch. If anyone's gonna die, it's gonna be the swine wretch. Oh, one hit point. That is unfortunate. What do you need to go next? Alright, well, we can still kill the swine wretch or the cultist brawler, as I think is better. Yeah, let's go for that. This party's gonna be a bit stressed out. Because I'm playing poorly. Rabies, no! Always get rabies somehow. Did they do something to make diseases more prevalent? Holy cow. Alright, let's see if we can't... I guess, honestly, it's gonna be go for the kill on the swine brat. Ugh. This is much less than ideal. I could potentially use Solemnity, which isn't bad. I could use Withstand, also quite good. Or I could try to chop this guy. Let's use Withstand. Seems unreasonable, I know. Entirely unreasonable. But, then again, I can also do this. She hits high enough that I'm not too worried. Nope, that won't help. What's this? Oh, solo. Yeah, okay, use a solo. Dodge in the back row there, that's fine. Resist as well, that's unfortunate. Now, the reason I did that is because I think that means she gets to do her forward lunge again. Ball and chain. Oh, no. That is very unfortunate. Son of a bitch. Alright. Get some damage back there. You may... Well, presumably you may. Go ahead and use medicinal herbs. Or should we not? Should we not? No, I want to actually get that kill. So let's use medicinal herbs. Now do it. Much better odds. Slice, slice, slice. That was good. This makes this a lot easier because now you've slid forward. A lot of stress going around. That makes me really unhappy. It might be time to switch up into the play stress-free music
this expedition
mode.
Expedition at least promises success.
Take the emeralds, please. Alright, listen up, bud. Your battle ballad, solo. Let's go get rid of... Yeah, let's get rid of solo for now. And switch to inspiring tune. Let's try that. Switch it around. Oh, less than ideal. How's your bleed? Not too bad? Okay. And we're gonna get more food here. Makeshift dining table. Oh, beautiful. I guess we can take all of it and just use whatever food is here to do that. Actually, we can probably just use up the remaining torches.
The light, the promise of safety.
And keep some extra food on hand. That'll be helpful. Okay, I'm banking on there not being a boss fight in this upcoming room. So, please don't be a boss fight. Okay. Please don't be a boss fight.
The match is struck. A blazing star is born.
Okay, we didn't get a boss fight. That's awesome. And we surprised them. Glorious. Okay, we can camp here. And then go for the boss fight. Wow, that is incredible. That damage just boggles my mind. Utterly boggles it. I feel like the bloodletter is bad, but not as bad as like a brigand cutthroat. But then again, I also don't want to waste, you know? I don't want to waste hitting... Yeah, let's do the bloodletter. That's why, because it's so much damage. You don't want to waste that. Finale on the bloodletter. Absolutely. How is he still alive? No! Go for the Bola. And then that'll knock the corpse back, which won't help us at all. Or, here's the thing, we'll use the, this guy's, we're gonna have to use him anyways, so we might as well try and do some damage on one of these back row fellas. Yeah.
Precision.
Nice.
Power.
That was good. Bloody good shot. It was bloody good, in fact. And now you're gonna go for that, and please hit. Thank you.
The bigger the beast, the greater the glory.
That leaves you with slice and dice, a little bit of damage. Nothing to worry about at this point. And there's your face gone. Dirk stab. Nicely done. Uh-oh.
Be wary. Triumphant Ooh. Pride precipitates a dizzying fall.
We've hit that spot now where, again, we have to dispose of things that we don't want to dispose of, truthfully. Like, the emeralds are pretty cool. The onyxes are pretty cool. These are things that I would like to keep. You know? But that's not going to happen. So I'll get rid of the onyxes. Take the heads. Always. Always, always. Oh, okay. We could actually camp here and then pick up a bunch of food after. That's very reasonable. Let's do that.
A spark without kindling is a goal without hope.
Shoot! I should have mixed up the party before camping. Oh, well. Okay. Snuff box on whoever's got the disease. Rabies on Brian. Perfect. So use snuffbox on Brian. Rabies cured. Thank you. Alright, Brian gets to do reflection. Absolutely. Thank you. You get to do tiger's eye. For some reason, it's a restring crossbow. Thank you. And for, like, this is insane. Tiger's eye. To further boost what? Accuracy and crit on her to make it utterly ridiculous. Or, and I think this might actually be a better call, use Tiger's Eye on him for that increased accuracy. Her accuracy is already high enough that it's probably always gonna hit. Yeah. There we go. Some good old song lyrics. Okay, I don't think we can do anything else. Feeling pretty good about this. Let's rest. Alright. Hopefully we don't get ambushed.
May we find victory.
Perfect. Okay, you go to the front, you go to the back, yeah, let's get some more food, thank you. Now, here's the fun part. I don't know how else to put this, but I actually want to go back for the wine. I want to do this. I think we can do this. I don't think it's going to be a problem. Potentially, I could just walk this way up through here. I don't know if that's worth it. We get one fight. We get one fight there. Nope, we're going to just backtrack. We're going to backtrack all the way to the wine barrel and then go down to the boss fight. That's it. Hopefully only one fight pops up between now and then. I honestly think we will get a fight popping up along this path. We might get attacked by the collector. I mean, anything is possible. But I also think this is worthwhile. 30% extra damage, right, is a worthwhile thing. We know this. I mean, imagine putting that, if you will, on this one. She's already got ridiculous damage. Utterly ridiculous. Every time she hits, she's going to massacre someone. Also, we can put it on the jet. Oh, shit! Ah!
Mind that such missteps are the exception and not the rule.
Shit. That was my bad. Alright, I get it. We got lots of food. We've been playing the food game. Okay, so. Plus 30% damage. On whom do we want it? He'll probably end up using Battle Ballad throughout. I think that would be worthwhile. That first finale isn't awful. But in all honesty, increased damage would look good on the leper, on Hendry. It would look good on most of these people, most of our folks. And it would look really good. Honestly, I can't help but say that increased damage would look most good on our person who already does an insane amount of damage. So let's put everything on Anna's grave robber attacks. The other thing too is she can attack anyone, anywhere, anytime. So let's go ahead and do that. You get to a barrel that reeks of powerful liquors. That's insane! We're ready for the boss fight. Let's just backtrack a bit. Don't backtrack too long now. Go, 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 go. Hurry, hurry. That's scary, man. There we go. We made it without any undue stress. Alright, I gotta be careful for traps. Keep the light. Feeling good. Look at that. They have adorable little feetsies. I've never really paid attention to them walking before. But look at their little feetsies, especially the leopard. Look at that adorable bandaged feetsie. Feetsie. Look at that one. You're so cute. Okay. Oh no, hunger. Hunger strikes again. That's okay. We're ready. We was born ready for this fight. I honestly have no idea what to expect. Oh god. Okay. Oh, I did not want this. You're gonna cause bleed.
Watch your step.
What does this do? I still have yet to figure out what occult scrawlings do. I think last time I put holy water on it, it was bad. Is that right? I think it was bad. Let's try it again. Let's see if holy water is good. Note to self, stop putting holy water on the damn thing. Wait, can I get rid of that with the medicinal herbs? Four combats. It's a debuff. So we're going to try and get rid of it. Oh, we did. Okay, good. That means we only get one finale now. We're out of debuff removers. That's fine. Let's do this, folks. Fingers crossed.
What squirming, the heck?
Contorting and ever expanding. This horror must be unmade.
What the heck? Okay, so it's one massive thing. Okay. Ah, I don't understand what this means. Okay, it's got 100 hit points, or all of them have 100 hit points. Is this a 400 hit point thing? Is that what's happening? I appreciate that whatever this part of it is a healing part. Okay? Whatever this part of it is probably an attacking part. So, the attacking part has more protection. Do we want to kill the healing part first? Is it actually 100 hit points? Is 400 hit points across the board is insane, or is it just collectively 100 hit points? It's probably collectively 100 hit points. I do not understand this. Okay, oh god. Wow, that is gross. Let's just kill the healing things first. Maybe. I don't know. I don't understand. The damage thing? The healing thing. The healing thing will take more damage, so let's do that. Okay. Okay. It heals itself. Oh, good. Undulating and bane. Oh, good. Of course it was going to do. It was always going to do that. We knew. But anyways, it's amazing that we do... Oh, yeah. We do glorious damage. Maybe I did do the right thing. Going for mad damage. If we can crit on a 33 and maybe like do like a 66 damage or something. I don't know if that's how it works. But I would love that. So please do it. 18 is cool. I will happily take 18. What can we do with your sniper shot? That is so uncomfortable. If they're all the same thing, then don't you technically want to just hit the non-damaging things? Oh, that's for stunning. Stunning would be ideal. What happens if I knock these back? Anything? Probably not. Our accuracy's not getting any higher. Oh my god. Yeah, just hurt it. Do we wanna... Oh, I didn't use Mark. I didn't use Mark. That's fine. Just hurt it then. Undulating invasion. Good thing we've got a couple anti-venoms. Alright, how are you doing for damage? Oh yeah, you're doing cute. You're doing cute. What happens if we hew? Here's a question. Will hew then do that damage to... You know, like 5 to 10, 5 to 10. And we might be able to do more with the hue, so let's maybe try that. Well, 15. Good. Whoa. That's not cool. What just happened? Take it easy. Holy cow. Okay, no. Okay, that's good. That's really good. See, notice that. We've got big bone walls now. So we have to hit past the bone walls to do more damage, and I think we can do that. Get a crit.
Devastating blow.
Nice. Think I'm done with you? Hardly. Absolutely. Use that. And I'm nervous. I don't know if you can tell. I am very nervous. Let's do a battle ballad. Just for that more speed. I like me some speed. Oh, leave the jester alone. I'm not ready to lose the jester. I'm not down with that. Sniper shot the shit out of these guys. Would the bone... Yeah, you're not moving those bone things. So, You actually have to just get past the bone wall.
Oh, come on.
Which means he's going to be pretty much useless. Yeah, I mean, what are you going to do? Huh? What are you going to do? 2 to 5 damage? Okay, that's not useless, actually. Go ahead and do it. And what do these walls do? Are they healing? Bone Zephyr. Oh, no. Oh, no. Please don't hit the Jester. Thank you. Okay, light damage and stun. Oh, that wasn't fun. Less than ideal. No.
The brink, facing the abyss.
Enough with my dead Jesters. Please be nice. No! I'm utterly uncomfortable. What is the Maw of Life? Good God! I hate this! This always keeps happening! This always keeps happening! This is my fault. This is utterly my fault, but damn it! If only we could just... Whatever. Go for gold. Go for gold, pony boy. No! Alright, if you can chop this... Look at that. Look at that, are you watching it? Oh, Hugh is better. Okay, yeah, we'll do Hugh. Or actually, a chop on that. No, Hugh is better, because then we got 2 times 90% chance. So we're going to Hugh, hopefully kill, and then that'll give us a chance to use the anti-venom on him, preventing him from dying. Alright.
It is as grotesque in death.
Wait, what?
It was in life.
Oh.
These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can be beaten.
That was scary. I'm glad we didn't lose anyone. I do need to figure out a better solution to this. This Arbalest Jester thing is cool, but it leaves whoever's in position 4 pretty vulnerable to not being able to heal. And when they do that, it's bad. So... that's poor gameplay on my part. Still, that was good. We've learned things about the Inchoate flesh. Terrifying, terrifying things. Ugh. Ugh. Right, we should feed. You'll stand, fight on. Yeah. Alright. Feels pretty good. Whoa, did you see that? There was something weird going on there. Huh, it scouted the boss fight. Okay, I think we're good. That was scary, man. We came pretty close to losing somebody. But we didn't. So we get some more treasure. 80%. 110. Presumably, in the upcoming fights, we will not die. Let's find some things to kill. There we go. Alright, best way to go might be... I think if we go up north here... less fights, more treasure, perhaps? Oh, yeah. Dinner cart. Perfect. That's what I was banking on. All of the food for healing. You're full. Don't be an idiot. Eat food. When somebody offers you food, you eat it. Alright, that'll do. Yeah. Presumably, that sucks about your death store. What does it say here? Death store recovery. Okay, so you're not actually a death store. You're in death store recovery. Let's fight. Let's get a nice surprise. We got some treasure there. That's good. Thank you for the surprise. We're going to lunge on forward and just kill anyone we choose. I guess we choose the Swine Drummer for some reason.
The ground quakes.
That's incredible. 49 crit. Go for that. Good effort. We can get a nice hue in on that as well. So, I might be able to kill them. I probably won't.
Impressive.
Not bad, though. The tide rises and the tide falls. Don't hit the Jester. Thank you. Very nice. Can we get a heal in, maybe? Let's do an inspiring tune. So you're pretty stressed there. That'll help. Let's get that stress down. We're going to quit this fight pretty soon anyway. Great, that worked really nicely.
Success so clearly in view.
All the other fights are quite simple.
Is it merely a trick of the light?
That inchoate flesh fight was pretty brutal, though. The contents are yours. Thanks. There we go. I think after every fight, they'll get hungry. Full. Yeah, let's still do this. Super disarmed. Maybe some more treasure. Something good? No, nothing good. That's fine. We'll finish this way because we want to avoid getting extra stress from backtracking. Alright, now we're going to go back this way. Light another torch, presumably. Admittedly, I feel like this party could absolutely take on a, what do you call it? Oh, a shambler. This party could take on a shambler. If we found one. I'll hold on to an extra torch in case one of these is a shambler or altar. Let's go down, around. Grave robber is really good for that. Alright, boost. Who do we want to boost? Her for more? I don't think you can double boost that, can you? Even if you could, we would want to. No, I don't have the things, so we'll just open the barrel. Stash, treasures, lame sauce. It's getting dark. We don't want it to get pitch black, though. I don't mind close to dark, I just mind pitch black. That's all you need to know. Feel free to chow down a bit. What can we get rid of? The bandages, perhaps? There, that makes the noises go away. The bandages or the holy water. I like both. Though holy water is perhaps less useful right now. Well, I guess we can get rid of them all. Do we need any of those? No, we do not need any shovels, so get rid of the shovels. Thanks. Ah, painful.
Mechanical hazards possessed by evil intent.
Awfully dark. Alright, well, we've got a fight coming up. We might actually want to use our... We'll just end up fighting a shambler in the dark. In the pitch black. After this fight.
Secrets and wonders can be found in the most tenebrous corners of this place.
This might have been a poor life choice. But it's also going to boost our crit chance, so that our crit chance is going to be very lovely. 8 to 13, 7 to 11. I want to get rid of the swine wretch. He's stressful and disease-causing. Thank you. Now, for some reason you get to go. Please don't hit the corpse. You're going to hit the corpse, aren't you?
Well struck.
That was an amazing blind fire. Thank you for that. Ball and chain. Don't stun. Ah. Our best unit. Look where it hurts. Go easy. Okay, I might have to actually just leave. The nice thing is he's a little bit back. Go for a good hit. Nice. A little bit of undue stress happening here. Ridiculously good. Okay. We got more things. That was worth it. We get a chest.
Brought low and driven into the mud.
I have mixed feelings now about fighting a shambler. I believe that we probably can't fight a shambler. God, those noises. And those noises are creepy. No, we'll keep going. We can kill a shambler. We can totally kill a shambler somehow. I don't know. Whatever. Do we want to go up and fight that? Yes. Don't cause stress. Nothing of value. We gotta fight. Easy. This is an easy fight. Now let her move. Oh! Oh, shoot. That was like the minimum damage she could have done. That's crazy. I should have done the other one. Poor life source. Let's get you to do withstand for that stress heal. I want to limit his stress as much as possible. Would it be at all oh, yeah, baby. Keep that stress low. And then you get to finish. Nice. That was pretty good.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
Take that. Alright, we're working our way up to the shambler fight. Straight across, and let's get that fight out of the way. Ooh. A little bit scary. Do I need to switch this? I do. I do need to switch this. You can see I'm starting to panic a bit. These noises, man. This game gets to you. We could avoid a shambler fight. Alright, I think we've got this. Maybe. Thank you! Dodge 24, that's the least you would expect. Go for the kill.
Masterfully executed.
That is so, so beautiful. Go for that. Good effort, good effort. Will the Bola do it? It'll probably do it. There we go. Oh, you missed. I should have used the stress heal. I should have used the stress heal. I'm an idiot. Great, now the jester's gonna be the one that's stressed out.
Seize this momentum. Push on to the task's end.
Get rid of the bandages. Torches or keys? No, we'll leave the 150 gold. Alright, you do that, you do that. And another scrawling thing. Okay, well, we know not to put holy water on the scrawlings. Go ahead and read them. Does anything good ever come from that? I mean, that's a deep question. Also, how much longer must I walk through this dungeon before I find a shambler? And is this a good idea? That's probably a good idea. That is scary, man. Just more food. Ugh. Disgusting. Ignore it. I mean, presumably, I can take on a shambler. Honestly, with her plus 30% damage until camp, and that, she's doing enough damage that if we just continue walking, we might find a shambler. And I don't know. I think we can do it. We could do it potentially in one hit. With the kind of crazy damage that she does. This might be just begging for trouble, though. I should probably leave. Do I get a bonus for going all the way back here? Watch the trap. Okay. Okay. I got you. Thanks. You know what? I might want to just leave. I can keep wandering for quite a while, but it's just going to keep raising their stress slowly. Oh. But I would love another ancestral trinket. I love another ancestral trinket. Let's keep doing this for a little bit. Just a little bit. Might work. How much food do we have left? Oh shit, we're out of food. Oh shit. Okay, that was it then. That is our cue to leave. Oh, that was scary. How we do for money? Well, not bad. 7,000. 1,100 gold. I think we made back what we lost in gold. We got a decent amount of portraits and other things. And hey, we got a cleansing crystal. Now, unfortunately, Anna is now resolved level 3. We got... Uh-oh, Hendry, don't cheat. Steady. That's actually not that bad. That's pretty cool. Yep, steady and resilient. They're both fine. Whew. That was sketch. That was very sketch.
In time, you will know the tragic extent of my failings.
How much did that heal? Mooneville is... Wow, look at that. Engaged in pleasures of the flesh and recovered 81 stress. But no bounce in his step. Apparently bounce in his step only comes from being in love with somebody back there. Effective disease treatment. It always scares me that there's ineffective disease treatment. Hopefully there isn't. Anyways, that was terrifying. I am glad that we are done with the, whatever. What are the next ones? Swine King? Swine Emperor, maybe? Swine God. Oh, good. That doesn't sound fun. The inchoate flesh. Phew. Alright, we're done with the Warrens. We need to do some ruins runs. So that's kind of cool. Stalwart Buckle. That's a really crappy one. We can probably sell that. But we totally... Oh, what's this kind of cool? Witch's Vial. The Witch's Vial is kind of cool. Yeah, we can do that. Alchemist. Yeah, the same thing always, eh? Old Blighting Satchel. Oh, mind you, I don't think we actually have one. That's pretty cool. The Wounding Helmet would be very cool for the Bounty Hunter. We should consider it. Quick Draw Charm. Ah, okay. So that's a fully first round. That's not a bad one, really. It's not bad. Especially for somebody who's a little bit slower. Because it wouldn't make much difference after the first round anyway. But it just means that a really slow hitter, you know. So a Crusader or especially the this guy could... possibly go first. That's kind of cool. Yeah. Alright, that was good. Our gold is doing okay. We're still in that 30 and 40 range. Right, none of that. With 16, I think we could. Houndmaster, fast healer, and compulsive. Ugh, compulsive is unfortunate, but we can probably just throw him in there and get him fixed right away. Right, that's not the one that we're going to upgrade. We're going to have to keep just hoarding them. Is the guild going to upgrade anything at all? Oh, training regimen. You better believe it. Yeah, hell yeah. Hell yeah. Though, I wouldn't mind that, but honestly, if we're looking at these crazy prices for most of these guys, yeah, let's do training regimen.
Every creature has a weakness. The wise hero trains for what he will face.
That's pretty cool. I'll take it. We've now hit, look at that. Look at that. Big time savings. We really do need to start boosting up the other things, but no, big time savings, so that's awesome. And that guild looks glorious. The blacksmith is what really needs upgrades. And that's going to require a butt ton. A metric butt ton of deeds. So hopefully we'll end up getting some more deeds as we go. Unequipable trinkets. Sort by rarity. There we go. We're starting to get a pretty nice collection of very rare and ancestral. Well, we need more ancestral ones. But yeah, that's pretty cool. Then those are money as well. Oh, we've got... When did we get that? I do not remember getting the Houndmaster's spiked collar. That's pretty awesome. That's very awesome. We can now use a Houndmaster. We're going to get that guy, maybe fix him up, maybe go with him right away. I think we'll fix him up. And that's really exciting. Also, Anna just kicks ass. Throw her in the Warrens, and she is a certified killer. Badass. You saw it, folks. You saw it. She's got all the right traits for just hitting like a truck. Like a truck. She got these nice balanced picks and knives that I spent a lot of money on, too. Okay, thanks so much for watching, folks. That was it for the Inchoate Flesh, and I will see you next time on Darkest Dungeon. Bye.